Welcome to Crafts with RFM. For this video, we are going to be creating a light box for product photography. Okay, so you will need a pen, a pair of scissors, I mean a ruler, and tape, and you will also need a pen. You will need two of these lights. These were bought from CGB. They are also in the description down below. Hopefully you can see this clearly. Okay, so you will need two of those. Okay, great. So you will also need a piece of A4 paper. I'm using this paper as it's thick paper, and we are gonna get a better image for our product if it is thick paper. You can use regular paper, but I would recommend thick paper. You will need 6 AAA batteries, so these batteries, 6 of them, and then you will also need a box. Just a regular box, a shoe box would also be acceptable. Okay, so what you first want to do is make yourself space. So I'm shooting in a light box, so I'm gonna take out the things of the light box that I don't need, and so that you can get a clearer image, well, video. Okay, so what you first want to do is cut away all of these. Okay, so do that. Okay, so I've cut them away from the sides. Okay, so what you want to do next is plan where you want to have the lights. So what I want to do is have the box like this, and have one light on this side, one light on this side. And the paper will be inside of here, and then you will be able to take the images. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna turn it like this. We're gonna take one of our lights, first open it and put 3 AAA batteries in there. And then you are gonna measure. So, let me show you. So you're gonna put it here, and you're gonna measure up. So it depends on how high you want it up. I think 4 centimeters with this bit of ruler. So there's a bit of my ruler that comes off. So I'm gonna measure 4 centimeters with that little bit of ruler. Then I am gonna get my pen, and I'm gonna draw that little line. And then across here, it's about 34 centimeters, and my light is 7 centimeters. So what you want to do is that you have an equal. So actually my light is around, you could say that it's actually 8 centimeters. So then you would do 8 on one side, 8 centimeters on one side. So where's this line? So you want to have it on the line here, 8 centimeters on one side, and then you stop. So you do it 16 here, and then you are gonna put your thing here and you're gonna trace around it and cut it out. So after you've done it on one side, so look, the light will just come in like that, and then it will show on the inside. You want to do that exactly the same with exactly the same measurements on the other side for your other light. So do that now. Okay, so now you have both of the boxes, and you have 2 holes. Okay, so now what you want to do is take both of your lights and put them each in here. And then you want it, whoops, put it back in, adjust it nicely, and then you want to tape it down. Okay, so, Okay, so now both of them are taped. They've been taped on the outside because that is gonna not cover this light. Okay, so let me show you now how it goes. So if you press this black button here, just simply press it. Whoops. The batteries must not be in right. Just double check. Whoops, the batteries I forgot to put in this one. Never forget the batteries, otherwise you'll be confused. Okay, so like that, simple. Okay, then press it and press this, and then your product will be laying here and you can get good product image. Now the thing is, you don't want this at the background. This is where your paper is gonna come in handy. Okay, so take one piece of this paper. So now what you're gonna do is you're gonna slide it in here. Just gonna slide it down and then you're gonna slide it up. Okay, so the thing is, you're just gonna place it down here and then you're gonna stick it down. Okay, so after you've stuck it down here, you're gonna lightly crease it, and then while you're holding it, also stick it down there. Okay, so now you are gonna do exactly the same thing at the top side, because you just wanna make sure that you have got a nice way. So you've got this here, and then you've got this here, and now you're gonna stick this down here. Now don't stick it that it's like a corner, because that's not gonna look nice. You have to move it a bit up, so just in case you the top piece of paper might be in the image. Okay, so now you have this here nice, and then it goes up here, so you can barely even tell that it changes, that you can only lightly tell. And in the picture, normally your product is anyway gonna be laying down here, and then you're only gonna see a little bit of the back. Okay, so now if the photographer wants to take a picture from the top, they need a hole at the top. So that is what you're gonna be doing now. So simply, what you're gonna do is you can take something like a cardboard piece of paper, and then you are gonna simply trace around and then make a little flap like that, and then just cut it out. Okay, so I meant it other way around. I traced it wrong way. So actually you want the flap coming up like this way. Okay, so open it like that. So you want it like this. You want a bit here and then a bit here. So make sure that you get rid of all of that, because if you look inside, some of the cardboard has actually fallen down. So clean that out. Okay, so you are actually done with your light box. So let us take some photography pictures and see how good it is. Okay, that is gonna bring me to the sponsor of this video. The sponsor of this video is Pick-a-Pin. Okay, so this is a company that makes pin button badges. So I have a set from them called Trendsetter. And let me show you guys this. This is how it looks like. There's one more badge that is... Okay, so these are the badges I want to photograph. The other one I don't like that much personally. It's this one because some people like waking up in the morning. So, I wouldn't actually wear this one. Okay, so that's why we're gonna take picture of all of these. So let's focus a bit so you guys can see it more. Okay, so let's put it at the bottom. So let me open it so you guys can see it better. Okay, so I'm gonna lay it out. Okay, so the actual company, all of their images were actually shot in one of these light boxes that was made personally by me. So it is nice. So later I will actually show you guys how all of her images look like. Her images are all also a bit edited, but not too much. Okay, so the camera I'm gonna be using is the Canon PowerShot G9. This is quite an old camera, but it is quite a nice one, so I like this one. Okay, so I'm gonna be taking the picture with this one. Okay, so now for you guys, it's gonna get a little bit darker because I'm gonna turn off the lights of the light box that I am shooting this video in. Okay, so I'm gonna turn it off, but now I'm gonna turn these lights on. So for you guys, now you guys can see just inside of the box. Okay, here's the flap. Open that. Okay, so I'm gonna turn on the camera. And I am gonna take the picture now. Okay, so you guys should probably know that I am not a photographer, so my pictures aren't gonna be as good as Pickapins, because that person has more experience. So this one's quite a blurry one, because I'm not very good at this. So let me just change some of the settings. Okay. So let me make it into a macro image, and then it will capture everything a bit better. Okay, so I need to make it a bit brighter because I've turned down the brightness. So this is not a blurry image. You guys just can't see it very good. There we go. This is the image that I have got. Okay, so this would need some editing. So let me just take another image just to show you guys. I need to turn up the brightness a bit of the camera because I turned it down before. Okay, so this is another good image. Quite good. For you guys, it's a bit blurry, but it's just because of the camera screen. Okay, so now I'm gonna try and take from the top here. So let me focus the camera a bit. Okay. Okay, let me try and take from up here, so I will need to zoom in a bit. Okay, let me focus it. And I've got a good image here. Okay, so now I'm gonna tell you guys what I'm gonna do with this box. Okay, so let me turn off the lights and turn on the light box so you guys can see again way clearer. So now you guys can see. There you go. Okay, so even if you don't have a camera and you still need to take pictures, a total normal iPhone or even a Samsung would normally work totally fine for this. Okay, so this box is a giveaway box. So down below, comment what you want to see in the next video. And one of you guys is going to win this box. All you have to do is pay for the delivery, because that would be fair, I think. Okay, so down below, comment, and now we're going to go check out Pick-A-Pin's website and actually see all of the images, and you will see how professionally they are. And all of that was shot in one of these boxes that I professionally made myself. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Also, down below, all the links for everything from the paper to the lights. Okay, and I will see you now at Pick-A-Pin website. Okay, so we are now at pickapin.com. So this image is not shot in a light box, but let's go to the shop. Okay, so all of these were shot in a light box. This not because this is not an image. Okay, so all of these were edited only a little bit, but they were all still shot in a light box. So I had this set. So this is their image in a light box. And then each individual one as well. And the back of the badge. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video. And I hope that you will make one of these light boxes if you need one, and succeed if you're gonna use it for a company. I will see you in the next video.